Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome to part number 10 of the Wales campaign for Medieval 2 Total War. Here we go, we are playing as Wales and we are besieging Nottingham with Melir Mae Ddu. We have to wait a couple of turns, so we will maintain the siege. Nice little army here, hopefully we can take Nottingham this part, and then we will be pushing hard towards Oxford and perhaps London as well. We're going to try and clean up some of these English towns as quickly as we can. We're doing very well on this campaign, which is, of course, very hard difficulty. And we are really doing our best to do well, if that makes sense. That's just the most stupid comment ever, but you get what I mean. So let's continue. I think we're at the end turn phase from the previous episode. We're on 12 turns so far. We've done a hell of a lot in 12 turns. If we have a quick evaluation of this video, because it is the 10th part, and this part will probably be an extra long episode as well, because it is episode 10. So we have 10 regions controlled, we have 5 castles, we have 3 battles lost, but I think one of them was a naval battle and two of them were when I besieged Lancaster up in the north, so we know we went wrong there. Year is 1269, we have won 17 battles, so we've done very well indeed. 5 cities, 8 generals, and we are on course for our victory conditions. We've of course got to get Dublin, which isn't really a problem, I guess, you know, we're going to try and get there. We're going to get London as well. We need to get Caernarfon, which we have, Dublin and London, and eliminate England. So with, let's see, with 8 settlements altogether, 5 castles, 5 cities and 5 castles, we're on course. We need to get 25, so that's fine. And of course, diplomacy, we are enemies of the rebels and England. I was hoping to try and get an ally in Scotland, but they may not come to our aid. But we are heading north, of course, with our diplomat. Where is he gone? I think he's up here. Madog will get to Norway, and we might try and get some trade with them. So we are looking to expand, possibly, with some of these settlements. And of course, keep things taken over nicely. Now, this army of Anselm Bapton looks like it's going to attack this fort. We haven't actually fought him yet, and it's been the story of this campaign, really, because he has been there with his big full stack army for ages. He's been back and forth, but he hasn't attacked me, so it's quite ironic, really. I think we're probably going to end the turn, so let's click end turn and go to part or episode number 13. Oh, turn 13, not episode. What am I talking about? So here we go. England are moving some troops around, it looks like. in, out. What the hell is that? Oh shit, look at this. Civil revolt in Lincoln. We kind of anticipated this because we couldn't really control it. We don't really care too much about that. Although we have now lost Lincoln because of it. So, whoopsie daisy. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We took everything and went out to try and take Nottingham. We're trying to take stuff away from the English, which is what we are doing. Faction announcements. So a family tragedy. Oh no, Senna is dead by the looks of it. And Rodri the Honest got a mean leader, so he's got a +1 dread skill there. Recruitment report, lots of troops being recruited in Montgomery, Caernarfon, and retrained in some of my other settlements as well, Shaftesbury being one of them. And the queues have been stalled because of lack of funds, so oh, that's bad. Looks like Anselm has not attacked the rebel fort, so he didn't go for it after all. And now I'm going to concentrate on the south in this part. Maridhi, there's a settlement. Oh, I don't know where it is. It might be right in the boot, right in the corner. Let's just creep up. It's here. Oh, and there's a rebel army. We can probably do this. Captain Perkin, 1 unit. Lancetown, 1 unit. Holy shit, we're going to take it. We're going to take this settlement. Let's attack Lancetown. Fucking assault it. We can probably auto-resolve this, guys. What is the point of fighting this one? We've got this big army here. We got Ballista. We should be fine, I think. Oh, saying that, though. Balance of power, 5-2. Richard. I'm going to fight this battle, because why not? See you on the battlefield, guys. Let's go. Let's go for it. Let's go and fight them. I could auto-resolve this, I know, but I could probably do this without taking any casualties or taking minimal casualties at the least. So it just seems, with the auto-resolve, I might lose like 100 men for the sake of it. You know how unpredictable in Total War games it can be. And I want to be a bit safe because this is a decent army I have. So we're going to take the Ballista. I'm going to put it right in the front of there. It's going to attack the guards for me. I'm going to group up this spearman. And we're going to put them right behind, like so. Cavalry is going to be grouped up as well. We're going to stick them. They can just go in the flank there. And all my bow units are going to be grouped up as well, because why the hell not? And they're going to be forming up some sort of formation in front of the spearmen. That looks fine by me. And of course, they only have one unit, and that is, of course, the general. I could just get the blister to continually fire upon the general in this battle, but I'm not going to just yet. I'm going to actually be fast-forwarding it. And the catapults can actually aim. Oops, fire at will, special ability. 15% damage. I'm just doing this in case it bugs out and I don't end up killing the general with my ballista. At least that way I know I can get more men in through the gates. So I'm just doing this quickly. 75%. 90%. Oh my goodness, one more should do it. Hell yeah, there we go. That is very, very nice indeed. So we are through. We're going to go back to normal speed. And the ballista is going to, in fact, aim at the general. I do have towers here, so I don't want to take too much damage from them either. So I'm happy enough for the ballista to kind of dance around there. The bows can come up a little bit, though. I'm going to fast forward yet again, because there's no point in wasting troops. That's the motto of this kind of battle. Just definitely no point in wasting troops. They have 23 cavalry at the moment, so we'll see what we can do with the ballistas. Hopefully we can get one or two decent shots. Although, looking at this, I'm probably going to be missing at this angle, so I may want to change that. I think I will, actually. Let's go back to normal speed. Yes, we are just in fact destroying this building rather than doing any real damage, so yeah, it's a shame. Doesn't matter. We're going to send this spearman unit, because it needs the most, it's the least experienced that I have, but also has the most men, so it's a good chance for him to get experience by killing the general. All the bows are going to have fire on and they're going to aim. Ballista's going to aim and the spearman's going to come out. And all the rest can just sit back and relax because we have this battle covered. There we go. So let's just fast forward it slightly.
Soldiers have proved their worth.
Oops.
Today.
There we go.
The enemy's walls belong to us.
For some
now.
Reason, these guys, where are they going? Dudes, where are you going? They're just going to stay out and get killed. They're going to get murdered. Holy shit. What are you doing, man? Spearman? I actually run the spearman unit out in case. In case they do charge. 23 of them still. This is kind of bad. It doesn't matter though. We are hopefully going to get some kills. Get the kills. Fast forward. It's going to be boring to watch, so we're just going to fast forward it slightly. While the arrows fly around. And the ballista flies in as well. There we go. Lovely. Spearmen can come in. Come in and walk in and play. Because why not? I'm actually going to tell all my bows to not use the flaming arrows. I'm going to use regular arrows. Because we can. Fast forward it a bit more. When he kills, it's bad. This is. It just shows how bad. I'm actually. Oh my god. Let's just go to normal speed for a sec. And let's get the ballista. Where's the range? Probably here. We've got some ammunition left, but do it like you can see what's going on. That's in the way, but probably by here we can probably get one up and over, so should be better for us really. I'm actually going to get my spearmen into some sort of formation along in front of this bow unit. Have we killed any more? No, we haven't killed any yet. Oh shit, this is a boring battle so far. I do apologize, guys, but you know what I'm like. I want to be very thorough with this. Oh shit, and they're charging. Go to normal speed. Form Shieldtron! Skilltron! Shit, we're gonna get speared. Now, hopefully, we'll get kills. Oh, don't tell me we're routing. We're not routing, it's okay. We got some kills. We should do well against them, especially in this position. My ballista can turn on and fire upon them. Even though my own men are there, but who cares? Oh, we're getting lots of kills now. Defeat is a distinct possibility. Six down to 16, let's fast forward it. Let's forward a bit more. 28 men remaining for us.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
I think we're doing okay.
Our men are winning the battle.
Winning the battle.
Like this,
5 against 16. See, the reason I'm doing this is it's my weakest unit out of the 4 spearmen units, so it's the one which I could throw away. My arrows are being used on them. On the enemy. Only 3 of them remaining. I couldn't injure in and take the capture point, but I can kill the general in this position, I think. And we've only got one left, the actual general himself, fighting to the death.
Good tidings.
And he's dead. There we go. Lovely.
All of
that was nice.
Will be by the
we won.
We have won here today.
We've taken it with minimal losses, just from the one unit, so it worked. 37. That works for me. So nice little victory for us. And we've taken another settlement from the English. Excellent. See if we play. We'll take out that rebel army as well, probably. Eventually. So there were some Welsh people in the settlement, but not many. I think it was like 10%. So I'm thinking probably sacking the settlement. We will loot some of them. We will loot and we will massacre. So a sack will probably work well for us here. So we've got some more money, which will stop the queuing. Oh, look at that fleet. Are they? Admiral Stephen. Jesus Christ. This army will have to be gone eventually. Oh, peasants. Ignore it. It's only peasants. So we've got the settlement. We've got the south under control now as well. Or part of the south. We can repair this. 8 florins, that's easy, we'll do that. And we can recruit a brothel. What will that do? It'll give us public order and a spy, which would be nice. Land clearance, we could do that eventually, but we don't need to worry about that for now. That will do for Launcetown. We've taken it. There's, of course, there's a fort here, but ignore them. If it's not too much of an issue. Shaftesbury, we need to start thinking about moving out of Shaftesbury, but we do have some units on the way. And we can recruit some stuff. Maybe a leather tanner eventually to get the padded armor. Would be nice, but for now we need to get some heavy units for King Llewellyn. He is sitting in the settlement, which I don't like. I like to move out as quickly as I can. And Edwin Riddick, we got a choice, Winchester or Oxford. Now if we go for Winchester, that cuts them off from Llewellyn and he can join up and try and take Arundel. I could go for Oxford, which only has 3 and 12% Welsh settlement. Winchester has 19%. All right, so we want to help the Welsh guys here. Let's go to Winchester in that case. Oh, we can assault them straight away at Winchester. Holy shit. Bang, bang, bang. We can fight them 1v1 is our strength. We're going to fight the battle for Winchester. We are taking the south at the moment. And I think that's probably going to be the name of this episode, taking the south, because we are doing that. Oh, God. Hope you guys are enjoying this campaign. I am really enjoying playing it. It's been fantastic. You can probably tell by my commentary, it's just so fun to actually play. That's not to say I don't enjoy playing Total War games and Total War campaigns, but you know what it's like on YouTube. Sometimes you play campaigns and they can be a bit, you know, you do it, you start one, and then you don't really enjoy it that much and don't end up finishing the campaign. You do like 6 episodes and then that's it. But this one, we've got the 10 so far, and we are definitely going to be completing this. It's like one of my goals for the year, basically, is to do this campaign and get up in a full playlist, and that is exactly what we are doing. It's going to be up. I'll probably get to the stage where I defeat England. Hopefully I defeat England, fingers crossed. And then we'll probably take a small break, and then we'll probably continue it and try and take all of Britain. That's kind of the aim that I have for the channel and for this campaign. We can probably use our bowmen, although they do have towers, so we need to think about this now. Would it be wise to try and jump in there? 75 spearmen. We have 75 ourselves. We do have the English billmen, heavy infantry, which we'll be using on the spearmen once we get in. Gonna fast forward this a bit more because save time. 48%, 60%, not long now. Maybe there. Oh, that's a terrible shot. Come on, get through, laddie, get through. 60%, come on. Oh my god. Oh, 72 was better. That was a direct hit there. Must take this settlement from them. Oh, 96. Let's go back normal speed. Because one more shot will do it. One more direct hit. And we've got plenty of ammunition to bombard the enemy with as well. So I may actually use these ballista units or catapult unit to actually attack the units on the wall as I march through. So that would be a good decision, I think. I'm going to send the billmen in first because they are heavy. They are taunting. They're going to be quite a good unit to use against the English. And we're in. There we go. Hell yeah. Right, we're not going to waste any more on that gate because we're in. So we're going to actually aim now for the spearmen. And the 2 billmen units are actually just going to march. Oh my god, let's get a proper formation. Let's go for the single formation, single file. And we're actually going to just march to the gate as we fire. Ballistas will hopefully start firing soon. Come on. Get a nice shot away. Don't hit my men, for God's sake. As expected, they have arrows. So now this is where we want to get our own arrows involved. Hopefully we get some kills. Might tear down the wall with them on it as well, which would be very nice for me. Oh, my bows again completely massacred. Shit. Look at this. That's the thing with these Hellweird Bowmen. They don't have the range of the other units. Oh, I don't want to lose them, so it might be wise to pull out. I'm going to pull out with them, I think. It'd be the safe option. No point in losing units like that. At least with a heavy buildman, you know that they have decent kind of ammunition. Gonna run in with them. They are gonna take some losses, of course, but I'm hoping that we will counteract that. What do they have? They have lots of spearmen mainly, so if we can just defeat the spearmen, we should be okay, I think. They are coming down from the wall by the looks of things. There we go, we're gonna charge in now. Charge in with the first bow, first unit. Charge in with the second unit. Charge in with the spearmen. Cavalry is in a position where we can run in if we need to. Ballista is continuing to fire. Oh, that's not a bad shot. Oh, it nearly was. Good shot. We'll aim for that spear militia because we're not far away from them. Building captured. Gateway. And the billmen are in now. That's right. Get them all in. And the spearman is going to charge them. Completely surround them and hopefully break them quickly. We live in hope. We're both taking losses. Need to be better by this. Spearmen need to get in there as well quickly. Hopefully my ballista can get some shots away for me. Now we will use the Hellweird Bowman to attack the spear militia on the wall. And my cavalry now is also going to come in. I know, unfortunately, we are against spearmen. I don't think they have anyone at the capture point. So we're going to try and ninja the capture point, I think, if we can get through. Well, balance of force is even at the moment. Hopefully my ballista doesn't hit my own men. Oh my god, don't hit my own men. Hit them on the wall if you want to hit somebody. Doing a half decent job. Spearmen are doing quite well. Billmen says victory is a distinct possibility. Now I need to get the cavalry through. The aim is to do that, get them here. We're going to give a rallying cry as we get through the gate, and hopefully we can charge in and get somewhere. We might take some losses, unfortunately, but the aim is to actually get in the building and get past them, which we are sort of doing. We haven't lost any cavalry units yet, so there we go. We've pretty much got in, so that's good.
Our men are winning the battle.
We're winning, actually.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
Fantastic. Could go for a charge on behind, actually, which is probably the best bet. Stay around, go for a charge. Oh, and building lost. Gateway is going and being captured. General's going to go charging back in. He's going to come charging back out. We're going to go for a nice little charge. Give another rallying cry. Ballista doing its job, and we are routing one of the spear militia. Look at that. Hell yeah. Now we envelop and we kill. No point going for any capture point when we can actually take the settlement.
Only half the enemy force remains.
We are winning, just about. That will do for me, though. Cavalry's going for another charge. Oh, look at that charge. He's dead. Hell yeah. Enemy general has fallen, Captain Morcar, and we've won. Let's kill them all. Kill them all. Don't lose my own general, though. Ballista. Oh, shit. The ballista better stop. Turn around. Get this bullshit off. Turn the ballistas around. Oh, my goodness gracious me. Right, that'll do. That'll do. Exit battle. Really quick, yes. That'll do. We took it. We are taking the south slowly. We are cutting them off. Winchester is ours. We made a good choice there, taking Winchester. Oxford only got 3 units, so it's undefended anyway. And I'm actually going to be sacking Winchester as well to get us some more money. The army routes. Enemy army routes. My spy now can be used to go probably towards... Oh, my God. Oxford is probably where we need to be, roughly. So, around Oxfordshire, so we can see what's in this area in case they go for Gloucester or Shrewsbury. But I think we've pretty much hit back everything in the south. Only little armies with 1 or 2 units are remaining, so nothing to be too concerned about. Oh my god, peasants. The big peasant army. The grand peasant army is there. Winchester. Let's have a quick look at Winchester. So we need to repair the gates, of course, which is 48 florins. We're going to retrain. Eventually, we are going to retrain those billmen because they're going to be quite useful. We can recruit some spear militia. Let's do it. Try and replace some of the units. I mean, we'll try and build some stuff here as well. Eventually, we will need it to get some more money and stuff. But I think we're doing extremely well. Nottingham is the last one we need to take. If we take Nottingham, which we can attack this turn, we are going to be looking very good in this campaign. They'll only have London, Arundel, Oxford, and I think they got Norwich or Ipswich around here. Well, around here, I think, can't remember where it is. And York, Carlisle, and Newcastle. I think that's pretty much it. We are winning this war against the English, but I am going to be ending the episode here. So I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.